Hey everybody, this is Fox and Sandra, and welcome back to LEGO Star Wars, and vague professionalism as I let the game explain its own story, and don't act like a twat. But anyways, like the story said, trying to find ourselves a pilot. I wonder who it could be. Certainly not someone played by Harrison Ford in one of his most iconic roles. Again. A carrot. Giant carrot. I wonder what we could do with that. Also, here's another thing they introduced in the second game. Double score areas. This admittedly very small area. Everything we get in there, we have a double score multiplier. We get twice as much. But it's very small, so who cares? Some of them are a bit bigger. Some of them are big enough to actually matter, but... Get rid of these guys. Change the music. So yeah, breaking trash cans, killing womp rats. Lots of ways to get some good amount of studs. I was about to say gold again. I really like to call any kind of money gold. That, I'm pretty sure we can do this right now. Boing boing. I mean, for our 2,000 stats. Have a blue stud in here. This is a fairly important level as it will introduce a new mechanic. And probably not one of my favorite ones just because of everything, but it's not a bad mechanic by any means. I just don't feel like they used it correctly. But anyway, so we got plenty of stormtroopers up there. But first... Oh, forget it. Yeah, they're not going to let us do anything else first. So we got lots of stormtroopers up there. But we can't get there, except... Yes, we can. Let's get us... a ramp. Let's get us a ramp. Damn you. Let me finish this. There we go. Yep, going. Now, one weird thing that happens in this area quite a bit is that that's a stormtrooper-only area. Like, I have seen multiple times stormtroopers go through this door and then leave it open. Like, and I don't know what causes it. Like, it happens, but then it, you know, doesn't happen every time, obviously. And it's not like it's a huge, like, sequence break either. Not really, because you need more abilities. But for right now, let's actually do the level as intended. Here, and then, of course, I do wish we could just, come on, push them out of the way, and open to the door. So yeah, and then obviously the, stormtrooper door opens that, which is definitely something they do a lot more of in, this game is, or this section of the game is the multiple routes to the same place. The areas are more interconnected. Yoink, yoink. Go there. Go away. Look, we'll kung fu you to death. Alright, so, we got some big ol' debris to clear out. It's more than we can get rid of with our dinky lightsaber, and Obi-Wan can't force it. So, what's the solution? It's quite simple. And people who know Lego and Star Wars can probably already see what's where we're going here. We're going to build ourselves an AT-AT. No. AT-ST. AT-ST are the small ones. I forget sometimes which are which. I'll fully capture that. Alright, but we don't have enough pieces. Let's get some more. We're going to take them out of the thing, and then we can put them on our work table, I guess. And this just seems unnecessary. Like, did you have to make this a cliff then? Like, why not just... I don't know. Again, just... You have to babysit protocol droids so much. At the very least, they can't die, so it's not like an actual escort mission or anything, but... If there's a protocol droid in a mission, you can bet there are many puzzles centered around trying to get him where he needs to go. But, so yes. Also, so we built this, and now this random mook just comes in and says, hey, give me that. And then we say, no. Just force him right out. You can also, if you hit him, I think he's got the 4 HP you do, 4 or 5 HP you do. So you can also just, blow yourself up. Not quite sure what happened there. And blow up a lot of other stuff. Why not? Go away! AT-AT duel! I love that you can step on them, but I don't love that that doesn't do any damage. Ah, crap, crap, crap. Well, crap, 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 I'm going to die! Oh, wait, that doesn't actually do anything. I may lose stats, but... Okay, come on. Get out of there. Again, the fact that you can't destroy them in a scenario like this is kind of annoying. Like, even if you, like, destroyed them and then you had to rebuild them. And could rebuild them. Like, that would make sense to me. And then would also prevent you from, like... You know... Go away! Also prevent you from, like, getting yourself locked out of secrets or anything. But, yeah, they're very annoying. And I think Luke is currently stuck under one. Yep. Well, whatever. He'll get out eventually. He'll teleport himself out. Alright. I find this just slightly odd, this puzzle, just because it's like, okay, we're in the Mos Eisley Cantina, and they don't allow droids here, so clearly we just don't bring the droids in. Now we gotta destroy these weird repulsor beams. And then we can open the door. Alright, and... Alright, so, now we have switched up characters. We are no longer Obi-Wan and Luke. Now we are Han and Chewie. Blow up this place for just no reason. One thing I really like about Han is that his blaster fires faster than, his little, like, laser pistol fires faster than other blasters. And so, you know, that's... It doesn't... And since it's... Most things only take one damage, you know. I don't think it does less damage anyways, so... But a little bit of puzzle solving now. Okay, does this episode... No, this episode introduces it. Whee! Ah, crap. So yeah, we're tracing down that weird spy. That, elephant-nosed spy from... Who for some reason is also a playable character, because, you know, you wanted to play as Imperial Spy, right? But not Sebulba. I don't know why, but that's still gonna continue to bug me. Alright, but we have to do... You probably saw him blow up the way out, so what we've got to do is... Pull this down. And the bomb dispersal... The pushable bomb disposal... Oh, come on. Ah, crap. No. Come on. On. That wasn't far enough, was it? Nope, it was. We still need to... Oh, there we go. And then we shoot. Alright. Gonna keep running away. Die! Die, all you guys! So if you're doing what I just did, you're gonna miss a, and just shooting the crap out of, just mashing the fire button, you're gonna miss a important hint on what you're supposed to do next. Because otherwise there's no hint on what you're supposed to do. Except the fact that it points out, yes, we've got, you know, we've got creatures here. You should probably do something with them. Well, what can we do with them? Can't seem to... They can bite, but that doesn't do us anything. You can jump super high off them. Also, remember the hat mechanism? That actually serves a point. So all those doors that we can only get through if you are Imperial, we can now get through. Just to show this off. They're going to require this for progress a little bit later, but... You know. Oh, wait, no. Ah, forget it. Again, vague professionalism, not actually, you know, like, working out what I should be saying or anything. I don't think I realized he couldn't shoot these from the back. That's just kind of weird. Anywho. So what you want to do is jump over to here. I remember the first time I played this, I was just like running around just like, okay, so I can get through these doors now. Which door do I need to go through and backtrack for? And I like backtrack through half the level. But no, you basically, you just can. And hey, everyone's back at our ship now. Unfortunately, that stupid mouse elephant spy thingy. I think the real thing that annoys me about the helmet is that the first time you get hit, it gets knocked off. And that means that if you have to, like, you know, that can make it kind of hard to get to where you need to go with the helmet. At least if you're like me and you want to play impatiently. It just seems like, you know, why not give us... Well, you'll see what we do get, and it's kind of like, well, why not just expand that a little? Okay. Stupid spies continue to call in a ton of reinforcements. Luckily, you know, I don't quite remember this many of them ambushing ambushing the Millennium Falcon. And another wave, but now he has a health bar, so let's just shoot the crap out of him. He's gonna be running into these doors, and he can just sort of teleport through them, but only he's at 4 HP, so down he goes. A lot of sort of weird mood whiplash, like with the guard just sort of sleeping on their thing and her, and then it's just like, but yeah, just a planet just got destroyed. I don't know. Of course, it's a Lego planet, so I don't know. Anywho, that'll be the end of this episode. So, thank you for watching. This has been Vox Insanity, and I will see you guys for the next time. Bye-bye.